POW Expert! Top 10 Antiques and Collectibles Tips. POW Expert publishes quick how-to guides on all topics from A to Z by everyday experts. Visit howexpert.com to learn more. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more POW Expert Top 10 videos in the future. Moving on, let's talk about the POW Expert Top 10 Antiques and Collectibles Tips. The world of collectibles and antiques began with small antique shops and auctions that offered buyers a chance to buy and preserve a piece of history. Today, this hobby has grown into clubs, conventions, and museums. Depending on your collection, it can also be used as part of your retirement plan. This book tells you how to get started and ways to grow from there. Here are 10 tips that give you a sneak peek into the pages inside this book. Number 10. Pick an item to collect. What speaks to you? Is there a gift that someone gave you that holds sentimental value? It can be something, such as a figurine or a napkin ring that you would like to build into a collection. Is there a hobby that you enjoy, such as bowling, photography, or skiing? Do you have a favorite animal or character that you're so fond of that you would like to collect more pieces of for a collection? Is there a toy or object that reminds you of your childhood? Once you explore the possibilities, you may even find more than one item to collect. Number 9. Purchase a journal and keep it as your go-to place for information on your collection. Custom design your journal with sticky notes and washi tape so it has different categories. Through your collection journey, take note of any information that you learn about makers and the pieces themselves. In your journal, list resourceful websites or social media sites and contacts of fellow collectors or antique dealers. When you find peer groups, museums, or events built around your collectibles, include all of that in your journal. Number 8. Now that you've chosen your collectible, learn about the history behind it. Collectors enjoy talking about the history of their collections. Some items have a pretty fascinating story of how they came to be. The more you know about your treasured piece's history, the better you will determine their age and value. Number 7. Now consider where you will store your collection. As much as you want to showcase your collection, space could be an issue. If the item is small, use a little creativity. A decorative board with hooks can display a collection of keychains or ornaments. If a lack of room requires you to rotate the pieces on display, make sure you store the others in a waterproof container. Number 6. Learn the meaning behind the labels and symbols. Each collectible has a mark or a logo representing the piece and possibly the year it was created. Are there numbers on the emblem that describe the date it was made or the year a patent on the product was given? Typically, any mark or set of numbers is there for a reason. Number 5. Learn the ways to tell the difference between an original piece from a replica. For some collectors, reproductions are perfectly acceptable. Still, you want to know how to tell the difference. Some collectors like to have both. They store the original safely away and put the replica on display. Number 4. Keep your collectibles in top shape. It saves the value and the piece in general. Restoring items can be tricky with older objects. Inside this book are resourceful tips on cleaning and restoring. The golden rule here is, when in doubt, ask an expert. Number 3. Meet other collectors. Are there people who share a similar fondness for cookie jars or sleds? As fun as it is to meet other collectors and learn the history behind what got them started, it's even better when they collect the same item as you. You can trade and shop together. If you save carousels but you cannot find a club in your area, then do the next best thing. Find collectors and start a club yourself. You might also find a museum that houses the treasures you are collecting. Number 2. Look into an insurance plan to protect your collectibles, the way you do for your home, car, and perhaps even your jewelry. Some homeowners insurance will let you add on to it. But in most cases, consider a separate policy for it. As well-intended as you are at protecting your collectibles, bad things do happen, such as fire, floods, and burglaries. Number 1. If the time comes that you want to sell your treasured pieces, do the research first. The first thing you want to know is the value. You can compare your item at auction sites like eBay or have it appraised by an antique dealer. Then, decide if this item can be sold online and consider how it will be shipped or packed up. Or is it better sold at an auction house or antique shop? So after you know the value, decide the best direction to take to sell the piece. If you liked our video, be sure to click like and subscribe for more How Expert Top 10 videos for all topics from A to Z in the future. Also, let us know what other topics you want us to do a How Expert Top 10 video in the future in the comments below. Thank you, have an amazing day, and take care. How Expert publishes quick how-to guides on all topics from A to Z by everyday experts. Visit howexpert.com to learn more.